Zambian opposition leader Hakainde Hichilema secured a shock landslide victory in the nation's presidential election. Electoral Commission of Zambia chairman Esau Chulu announced the victory over incumbent president Edgar Lungu after a briefing early on Monday in the capital, Lusaka.
Hichilema Hakainde is 2,810,757, 2,810,757. I therefore declare the said Hichilema Hakainde S to be President-elect of the Republic of Zambia this 16th day of August 2021.
All right, so joining us to talk about what lies ahead for Mr. Hichilema, or President-elect Hichilema, is Damilola Olukbona, who is an analyst with Chapel Hill Denham. Damilola, good morning to you. Thank you so much for joining us. So that's my first question to you, sir. What challenges await the President-elect in the South African nation of Zambia?
Well, the Zambian President-elect Hichilema has very huge challenges ahead of him. Unfortunately for him, he's inheriting some problems, you know, that came about as a result of the mismanagement, you know, from the prior president. So I think first on his bucket list would be to resolve the debt crisis, you know, Zambia has found himself in. Currently at the moment, debt to GDP is hovering around 100%, you know, which is worrisome. Earlier, some time ago, Zambia defaulted in its Eurobond payment, and, you know, that has just clouded, you know, foreign sentiment, you know, across Ghana. So I think the first major challenge on his bucket list would be on the financial side to ensure that there is financial stability, solve the debt crisis. Currently, Zambia is also facing elevated headline inflationary woes. You would also see to that as well. And I mean, the issues around FX revenue, you know, which is largely tied to Zambia's biggest export revenue, you know, which is copper. It will also see to ensuring that the stakeholders on that front are also pleased as well. So I think over the next few years or few months, he has a very huge challenge ahead of him. But I think the first one would be to solve the debt crisis.
Fantastic. So speaking of debt, how tricky will it be to try to restructure debts from the IMF while also asking for a bailout? Because I think it's also going to be talking to them. How complicated is that talk going to be?
Yeah, it's a bit complicated, but just looking at IMF's body language and how they've handled similar crises in the past, I know IMF is always willing to sit at the negotiation table with any country as long as the country is willing to meet their requirement. You know, like in the case of Egypt, they were given certain times on condition to fulfill. And after Egypt was able to fulfill them, they got IMF funding, I think, to the tune of about $40 billion. So I think Zambia's case will not be an exception. Already we heard that Zambia is in the process of securing a deal with IMF. Just recently we heard the economic parameters and objectives, you know, that will underpin the bailout, you know, have been set in motion. So I think IMF officials will just need to sit with the new president and see if the progress or the agreement they already had with the prior president sits well with him. And from there, we can move on with it. But I think it's something that is doable, you know, given the situation Zambia find themselves. So Zambia would have to do most of the heavy lifting in this case.
Speaking of heavy lifting, when you have double-digit inflation of nearly 27%, what steps can you take to bring such high inflation down?
Okay. In Zambia's case, the inflationary pressures they are currently facing is largely coming from the food side. So we've seen basic food items like chicken, meat, and the essential food items, you know, we've seen prices of those items, you know, skyrocket over the past few months. So first of all, I think I'll use the word intertwining effect in that if the president is able to solve the debt challenges, then we would begin to see foreign investors, you know, come back to the economy, which would mean more dollars, you know, flowing into the economy, and that would solve the current FX challenges, you know, faced by Zambia, which in turn would improve, I mean, in terms of importation of these food items and these things that will reduce prices, you know, which in turn would stem the pressure we are seeing on inflation. So I think, solving the problem might not be immediate. It will take a bit of time. But then to fix those problems, they have to fix various supply-side bottlenecks, of which FX seem to be at the center.
Great stuff. You mentioned copper miners. Some of them have said they've held back investment because of the business environment. How does he tackle that?
First of all, you will need to sit with them. I think one of the major problems facing the copper miners is the tax regime. Current Zambian administration is doing is to adopt a sliding. I think tax approach or pricing approach, which would mean depending on the international prices of copper, you know, the various entities will have to pay differing amounts. So for the investors in this case, when international copper prices are lower, they tend to gain, and when it's higher, as it is at the moment, you know, they tend to lose, and that has cast a layer of doubt, you know, in that space, and we've seen many major investors, you know, seeking to pull out of the Zambian economy. So I think the first thing he needs to do is to sit with them and, if possible, agree on the way forward. The investors are proposing that there should be a direct charge as against a variable tax regime, you know, which moves either way depending on the prices. It should be a direct charge, which will enable the players in that space plan and help them be able to carry out their activities.
Great stuff. Damilola Lukwana, analyst with Chapel Hill Denham. We'll have to see how things work out in Zambia. Thank you so much for taking us through that.